So we are going to learn refraction. Okay. So we were discussing before your midterm test the properties of light. Do you remember what did we learn? Can anyone just type what did we learn in the lesson light? So what is what are the optical instruments that we saw while we learning that properties of light? I hope you remember that. Srinija, so physics portion I have updated, so I'm sorry, sorry for the delay. We have the lesson namely light, so some portion from light, that is lesson 16, and stars and the solar system we have, and I think combustion and flame, so that is the only lesson. So even that we had, we can have these two lessons, namely light. Okay, so light is one lesson, stars and the solar system is another lesson. So as early as possible I will complete and share the notes. Okay, so don't worry Srinija and others, I am extremely sorry for the delay. Okay, so we have two lessons for the test. One is light, lesson number 16, okay, and stars and the solar system. So these two lessons we have to complete, and partially we have completed the light lesson, and we will complete the rest, and then we will have star and solar system. These two lessons will be for your next assessment. I will share the notes as early as possible, okay, this week. Okay, so reflection of light, fine, Srinija only has typed reflection of light. What about others? Please be active in the morning. Loss of reflection, Niranjana. So only Srinija and Niranjana are there. So I have to get the answers very quickly. So be fast. So Earth is rotating in a speed. So what is the speed of rotation of Earth? Try to find it. Okay. So clock is continuously moving. Okay. Flame is not there for. So Rahini is asking something. Combustion and flame is not there. Please check your revised portions. I will again confirm. Okay, fine. So be please quick and type what did we learn. So have you not observed the spectrum in a prism? Lateral inversion. So that is good, Nirjana. Lateral inversion. That is a mirror. Okay. So my right hand side will be left hand side in the mirror. Okay. And left will be right. That is called lateral inversion. Suppose you keep the pen like this in the mirror. This will be left for me, but in the mirror it will be right. This will be left. Okay. And Srinija, I get confused. So after the lesson, after the session, I will confirm the lessons. Okay. Fine. Dispersion of light. So that is the dispersion of light. Shona has said. So we have learnt about dispersion of light using a prism. I showed you some of the spectrum in the laboratory. Okay, isn't it? Fine. So today we shall see the other property called refraction. Okay, refraction. So I share my screen and type, and I will write the word refraction. Okay, so I have already written. Are you able to see the screen? Refraction. So you know what is reflection. Suppose if we have a plane mirror, some light falls on it and it is reflected back. Okay, light falls on it, it is reflected back. This is called reflection. So what is refraction? Okay, refraction means, so you have a mirror, so it's not a mirror, it is a plane glass. Okay, some light falls on it and it gets deviated. Okay, so without this glass it will be like this. So as the material glass is present, the light ray is getting deviated from the normal path. That is called refraction. So that we are going to learn in this lesson. So before that, I would like to show you a small experiment. See, so I have a glass. So I have a pencil. It's an empty glass. I have a pencil. Okay. So if possible, can you please go and get a silver tumbler like this, and you have some water on it, and use a pencil. Okay. So see. So I have a glass, empty glass, and I have a pencil here. The pencil is straight. Okay. So as far as possible, I will try to show closely to the camera. Okay. Enter full screen. Okay. So are you able to see the pencil? So now what I do is I just pour some water. Please observe this. I pour some water. What do you see now? Is it the same pencil or not? I look at the chat. Okay, Srinija, listen. Okay, so it is the same pencil, but you can see that there is a breakage in the pencil. Can you observe the breakage in the pencil, everyone? Same pencil, but you can see that the pencil is broken. It appears to be broken. Okay, so you can see this side. See, can you see the pencil broken? Yes. Others? Okay, little bigger and as well as broken. Ramarish, not breaked. It is break, broke, broken. Okay, so past participle is broken, not breaked. Fine. Now, what is the reason? What is the reason to see this pencil as broken? Okay, so that is the property called refraction. So if possible, you just go to your kitchen and take a, so after the class, you can go to your kitchen and take a tumbler like this and keep a pencil like this. No issues, Ramanish. Just it's learning, okay? Keep some pencil here. You look at it and then you just pour some water and then observe what you see, okay? That is, so a light ray that is coming out of some other medium. So here, what are the medium? So I have water inside, okay. I have air inside, okay. So here it is air, here you have water, okay. So therefore, a light ray travels through air as well as water. So when the light ray travels, so that means, so how you are able to see the pencil? The light which is falling on the pencil is reflected. That reflected light passes through air. Again, in this glass, the light ray which is falling on the pencil is reflected, but it is traveling through water. Okay, the light ray. Yes, Raja Rishika, you can also observe in a silver tumbler. You can do. You can just look at the top. Okay, you can observe this breaking of the pencil in a silver tumbler. You can see it because the light ray which is traveling in air is undeviated. It is passing in a straight line. Suppose the same light ray which is reflected from the pencil that travels through water and then it travels through air to reach your eye. Okay, if I keep like this, if I have some water, okay, the light ray from the pencil comes first from the water and then it travels through air to reach my eye. Are you able to understand? Okay, now what are the two media involved here? One is air, another one is water. Okay, that means a light ray, when it travels from a medium and it enters through other medium, it changes its direction. Okay, a light ray, when it travels through different medium, it changes its direction. That is called refraction. Okay, I will draw the diagram and you can understand better. So look into the, okay, so magnified, somebody is typing magnified. Okay, see, now I shall draw the same diagram. given in the book. Okay, I have a beaker, I have some amount of water. So the simple experiment, you can also do it at your home. Okay, so fine. Now I put a pencil. Okay, I put a pencil. This pencil is like this. Actually, I put the pencil like this. So it seems to be bent. Okay, the pencil seems to be bent. Why it is so? It means the light ray, please look at the other ray, pink. Okay, so you are observing from here. So you are observing at this edge. Okay, so you look at it. So the light ray which is coming out of water, suppose the light ray which is coming out of this water, okay, so this is the interface. Okay, it is the interface. Interface means where the air and water meets. Okay, light ray from the pencil is coming towards the surface of water and it is getting deviated, that is moving away from the normal. So that is why it seems to be bent. Okay, so to make it clear, I will draw another diagram. So you are observing here. Okay, you have I will give you some other example. So you have a small coin here. Say for example, you have a coin of 5 rupee coin here, and somebody is observing from here. So now if you have some amount of water inside, the light ray coming out of this water will be deviated and it will appear to be present here. Okay, the coin will appear to be here. Okay, and this is called a refraction. Okay, so when the light ray are oblique, so oblique means bent. Okay, so which is not perpendicular, that is the opposite of oblique. Okay, so oblique means a incident ray. Okay, so a ray which is oblique, that means which is not 90 degree, having 90 degree. Okay, a light ray that is oblique, when it travels from one medium to another medium, that is one medium to the second medium, the light ray changes its path. Okay, when a light ray travels from one medium to another medium, it changes its path. Okay, this bending or changing of its path is called what? Refraction. So it is a daily observation. Okay, it is nothing but a daily observation. And I will give you one more example. You just take a tumbler. Okay, so after the class you can try it with your people in your home. Okay, you have a tumbler, you have some coin, you can get a small bigger tumbler, you have some coin, and put this coin at the center of the glass tumbler. Okay, you just put the coin at the center of the glass tumbler, you keep like this, and ask your mother or brother or sister to see whether the coin is viewed or not to some extent. Suppose the edge of the coin is, suppose the edge of the coin is seen by the other person, just ask them to go away, just a little bit away, and then now pour some water. Suppose if you pour some water, okay, so initially the coin was not seen. When you pour some water, what will happen? The light ray from the coin will be deviated. So I will draw the diagram so that you will understand. So please look at the screen. So please try to understand. If you have any question, ask. Okay, fine. So this is another simple experiment you can do at your home to appreciate the refraction of light. Okay, fine. So you have a tumbler, you have a coin. Put some coin here, 5 rupee coin or 1 rupee coin here, and ask the person. So the person who is at your home, ask them to look at the coin. Okay, they ask them to come closer towards the tumbler. Okay, suppose they see the edge. Suppose they are here, and if they are able to see the edge, that is this edge. Suppose they are able to see this edge, just ask them to remain there. Now, so they should be standing here. suppose they are able to see the edge just at this place, please ask them to stand there. Now pour some amount of water. Okay, pour some water and gradually fill up the tumbler with water. Now at the same position of glass and the person, they will be able to see the entire coin here. That is, the coin will seems to be moved towards the left. Okay, that is what is happening is that when you pour some water, the light ray which is coming from this coin gets deviated. Okay, gets bent. Okay, at this point of water and air interface. So that seems that the coin is at the edge. Okay, suppose the coin is at the center. So after pouring some amount of water, the coin seems to be at the edge, so that they will be able to see the entire coin. Initially the coin is at the center, even now the coin is at the center, but that will appear to the person who is looking at the coin. The coin is at the edge. They will be able to see the complete coin. Initially they were able to see only the edge. Now they can see the complete coin. That means the light ray coming out of this water is deviated. Okay, now we shall see. I say that the light ray is deviated. How much deviated? What is the rule that we are going to see? Are you able to understand the experiments I told? Were you all able to understand? Because I haven't told the rules. So only now I am going to say the exact rule. How does a coin appear? Okay, that I told you as an experiment. You put some coin at the center, ask the person to see the edge of the coin. Now at the same position, fill up the tumbler with water. Now they will be able to see the entire coin. How does this happen? That we are going to see. Are you all able to understand what I am going to say? Is there any question? Is there any question? No. Okay, now I shall tell you the laws of refraction. Please look at the slide, look at the screen. If you have any questions, please stop me and ask. Okay, now I have a plane. Okay, so I consider a plane. Say for example, XY is a plane. And this plane is nothing but the interface. Okay, I can take this as an interface. Here I have air. This may be a glass plate. Okay, this may be a glass plate. Fine. So it is a transparent glass. Okay, it is a transparent glass. So don't worry much. So this is just a interface. Okay, I have a, assume that this is a glass plate. I have a glass plate here. Okay, it is a transparent glass plate. This is air. This is glass. Now some light is going to pass through. I am going to make incident of some light ray. Say for example, torch light. You can just make some beam of light to pass it on the transparent glass. Light ray falls on the glass. After falling on this interface, so this is, as if you consider this as a glass, this is air, this is glass, interface, air and glass. At this point, the light ray, that is deviated. Okay, how does it is deviated, that we shall see. So look into the screen. Now I consider an incident ray. This is the incident ray. Okay, this is the incident ray. So listen to the terms. Incident, I-N-C-I-D-E-N-T. So what is XY? XY is the interface between air and glass. Okay, this is incident ray, a light ray. For simplicity, I have taken only one ray. Okay, a light ray falls on the interface, and this point where the light ray falls is called the point of incidence. Point of incidence. What is the name? Point of incidence. and I have a straight line which is perpendicular to the glass plate. I draw a straight line which is perpendicular to the glass plate or the interface. Assume that this is perpendicular line, and this is called normal. Normal means it is having an angle of 90 degree with the interface. Okay, now we are learning the theory of refraction. Okay, you have an interface, you have incident light, and this light falls at an angle of I, and this I is the angle. Angle I is measured from the normal and incident light. Say for example, AB is the incident light, and MN, you can take, or MB may be taken to be normal. Okay, so this is incident light, and this angle measured from the normal to the incident light is taken to be what? Angle of incidence. Angle of incidence. Okay, and what will happen if there is no glass plate? This light ray will be moving like this. It will be going like this. Suppose there is no glass plate. As there is a glass plate, this light ray has deviated its path. It has now deviated. Actually, this is not the light ray that is emerging out of the glass. This is the light ray. This ray, say for example, A, B, you can call it as C. Okay? This B, C is called what? This is a refracted light. Okay? This is called refracted. Okay? A refracted ray. Okay? Incident ray, refracted ray, normal, and the angle from the normal, so this is also the green line is normal. Okay, green line is normal. Normal means a perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. Okay, now the angle between normal and the refracted ray is the angle of refraction. This is called the angle of refraction. Okay, angle of refraction. And you can see that there is an angle between the straight line, red, okay? And this you can call it as D. This AD is the incident light. Suppose there is no glass plate, AD will be the path. As there is a glass plate, it has deviated its direction. Therefore, the angle between the deviated ray or the refracted ray is called the angle of deviation. So angle D is nothing but the angle of deviation. Are you able to understand? You have an interface XY, incident light AB that falls on the glass plate. After refraction, it goes towards BC. Okay, BC. Without the glass plate, the path will be AD. And I is the angle of incidence, angle between the normal and incident light. And this is called the angle of refraction, angle between the normal and the refracted ray. D is the angle between the straight ray, okay, the path, the straight path, and the deviated ray. This is called the deviated ray. Refracted ray, angle between the refracted ray and the straight ray is called angle of deviation. Okay, so this is about the refraction of light, the theory. Okay, so are you able to understand? Okay, you have an interface, light ray falls on it, it changes its direction after entering into the glass plate. Okay, and normal is nothing but a perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. Suppose the point is on this point. At this point, I can draw a normal, that is called a normal. That is the perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. Okay. You have incident ray, normal, refracted ray, and deviated ray. Okay. And deviated and refracted ray, both are same. Suppose there is no glass plate, the angle of deviation will be zero. As there is a glass plate, D is the angle of deviation. It has to go like this. As there is a glass plate, the light changes its direction. Are you able to understand? So this should be the straight line towards the camera. Okay, I bring my pen. Okay, this is the straight line where the light has to go. As there is an interface glass, it changes its direction. So why does the light ray changes its direction? That we can see in the next class. Okay, so now again I will try to explain the concept of refraction using the same example. If you have not understood, please ask me again. You have a glass, you have a coin here. Initially, the people who is standing here is looking at the coin. They can see only the edge. Okay, and now you are going to fill it up. Okay, and now the people at the same distance can be able to see the entire coin. That means the light ray which is coming from this coin through this, what, at this junction, this is the point of incidence. Okay, here you have air, here you have water. Okay, at this point the light ray travels from a denser medium. I use the word denser medium, and it travels towards the rarer medium. Denser, rarer. Water is denser than air. Therefore, the light ray coming from the coin will deviate away from the normal. What is normal? Normal is the perpendicular line. You can draw normal at any point. Normal is the perpendicular line drawn at the point of incidence. At this point, the light ray deviates. Okay, from this normal, it deviates. So if you extend, or the light ray can also go like this. Okay, now if you extend this line backwards, you can see the light ray here. That is, the coin appears to be moved towards the edge, so that the people will be able to see the complete coin. Okay, so this is refraction. That means a light ray when travels from one medium, denser to rarer, or rarer to denser, it changes its path. That is called refraction. Simple examples I told you. So a glass and a pencil, you can try this. Okay, and the coin experiment you can try at your home. Okay, first ask them to see the edge and then pour some water. Now they will be able to see the complete coin. That means the light ray, when it reaches air from water, deviates from the normal, move away from the normal. Okay, and in the other example, suppose the light ray travels from air to water, that will move towards the normal. That we can see in the next class. Okay, so using this, we have several apparatus called the kaleidoscope, prism, etc. We can see in the next class. I will show you the kaleidoscope and some other pictures of dispersion of light, etc. in the next class. Should you have any questions? So please go through your textbook. In the meanwhile, I will share the notes. Okay. So whatever is taught in the class, please try to recall. Okay. Is there any question? We have more time. Is the concept understood? Shona, Srinija, others? Okay, no question? Okay, shall we close the session? We'll meet in the next class. So with some new concept, okay? Thank you all.